Hello. In this video, we're going to explore the central limit theorem, CLT, central limit theorem. So what I'm looking at here is an applet that you can find on a website from Rice University. So if you Google Rice University sampling distributions, and then you select the sample mean, this is what I'm working from. So let me go ahead and clear this out and explain to you what is exactly going on. Well, we're going to start with a normal distribution as the parent population. Now, what is the parent population? Well, it arises when we measure some numerical value, like let's say adult women's heights. So if we measure a woman's height, we write down that value and immediately put it in a pile. Eventually, all the piles will look like this. It'll be a normal distribution. This is a distribution of women's heights where the sample size is one. We're doing the measurement one at a time and immediately putting the values into a pile. Now, we're going to sample from this population distribution, and you're going to see the individual values fall down onto the second number line here. And then what you're going to see is we're going to average the values that are here on the second number line, and they're going to be placed as one value, a sample sample y bar or x bar. That's what will be here, a sample mean. All right. So we're going to start with the sample sizes 2, 5, and 25. And I'm going to go ahead and animate those. So here you saw two values come down from the population here, and then look at this. In the middle came the sample mean. Okay, so we'll do just a few of these so you can see. Let me go, there's five more samples, and so on and so forth. You can see there's a distribution trying to arise. Let's go ahead and make that 100,000 samples. And eventually what you would have is a distribution of sample means, which would be normal. It would look a lot like the parent population, but with a little bit less spread because the standard deviation is a little smaller, and the standard deviation is smaller because the sample size is a little larger. Instead of one, it's two. So we're already averaging here. Now let's clear this and do this for a sample size of five. I'm going to animate this so you could see it a couple times. Okay, so this value that just fell down is the average of all these five values. Okay, let's accelerate it. And here what you see is the distribution of sample means is normal, but much tighter. And of course you can see that the center or the mean of both distributions is the same. It's mu. It's the average height of all adult American women. And mu will not change. The only thing that changes is how quickly your samples pile up around the mean. Do they pile up quickly and therefore have very small standard deviation, or are they more spread out? Now watch what happens when we increase the sample size to 25. What do you think will happen? Well, let's go ahead and animate so you can see one example of taking a sample. And basically, this average of all these 25 values is one value here called a Y bar or X bar, a sample mean. Now let's accelerate this and look at that. You have a distribution that's very normal but extremely tight. Why? Because the sample size is much larger, so the standard deviation is much smaller. Now I'm going to go ahead and clear this, and instead of a normal distribution, we're going to look at a skewed distribution. This is our parent population. Could be something like incomes. We're going to do the same thing here. Start out with 2, then go to 5 and 25. I'll animate this a couple times so you can see it. And I see what's happening here. The averaging effect, even though it's small, it's still there. You have a value here and a value here. And look at the averaging effect goes to the center of the two values. Okay, let's accelerate this. And what you see is the distribution of sample means is not normal. It's skewed. It's a little less skewed than the parent population, but it's still not normal. Let's go ahead and increase our sample size. And I'll go ahead and accelerate the number of samples. And here it's already, we can see the distribution of sample means is becoming a lot more normal. There's a little bit of skewness, but it's certainly a lot better. And that's because the averaging effect is stronger. So we're becoming a little bit more normal. And now let's see what happens when we go to 25 sample size. We'll go ahead and go to 100,000 samples and look at that. The distribution of sample means is normal. So what we're saying here, and this is what the central limit theorem states, is that when the sample size gets large enough, It doesn't matter if my parent population is skewed or what it looks like. It doesn't matter if the parent population is not normal. The distribution of sample means will be normal. But remember, when we started out with a sample size of 2, we couldn't overcome the skewness in the population. So the only time that it didn't matter what sample size we used is if the parent population is normal. But if the parent population is not normal, then you have to ensure that the sample size is large enough. Large enough is 25 or 30. Our book uses 30. And let me just drive that point home so you can really see this. Suppose we have a custom distribution, and I'm making this about as weird as possible, as non-normal as possible. Okay? We're going to do the same thing, go from 2 to 5 to 25. Now, what you can see is the distribution of sample means is trying to fill in these gaps, which it will. So, for example, if I had a value here and here, the center would be here. But definitely not normal. Let's go to 5, sample size of 5. It's getting more normal. You can see it, but it's still not normal. And now, sample size of 25. Look at that. It's incredible. The distribution of sample means is normal, even though our parent population was about as far from being normal as possible. So again, just to recap, if your parent population is normal, then it doesn't matter what sample size you have. It can be a sample size of 2 or whatever. Your distribution of sample means will be normal. But if your parent population is not normal, then you have to have sample sizes that are large enough, and large enough is 30. All right. Thanks so much for listening.